Ethereum, world's second largest open public blockchain, announced in January 2014, already running for 5 years. What does it do? It offers a platform to create decentralized software. So it offers more flexibility than number one, a Bitcoin script. Of course, size doesn't matter. It's basically comparing a shark with a lion. They're not competing with each other because they both have other different use cases. Where Ethereum mainly, or Bitcoin mainly focus on sound money and the money app, Ethereum focuses on restructuring governance. How do they do this? With automated smart contracts, as we discussed before, based on a public ledger. In other words, removing the trusted intermediary and creating entirely new possibilities like decentralized forests, etc. We will do a very huge deep dive later on in Ethereum, so I won't do all the nitty-gritty parts here. But what you do need to realize is that Ethereum is a smart contract platform. It offers way more flexibility than Bitcoin, where the Bitcoin script is quite limited. As Vitalik Buterin, the original founder and his team, of course, the creator of Ethereum, discovered already, because they tried to build Ethereum once before, only then called it Mastercoin and tried to build this concept on Bitcoin. They quickly found out that Bitcoin wasn't very flexible enough, mainly focused on security instead of flexibility. Hence, the need of another different public blockchain was used, was needed, creating, of course, a new form of open, decentralized public blockchain. The concepts, though, are still similar as Bitcoin. So still removing the intermediary, still open source principles, also use a form of proof of work. Might be changing the consensus algorithm there in the future. We will discuss this as well. Important to realize here is it supports decentralized applications and therefore reforms or offers a chance to reform governance, aka the way we trust each other. Ethereum enables us to trust each other without a trusted third party. Instead of the trusted third party, we trust the code that is encoded in a decentralized consensus form running in a global ledger. So we don't need trusted intermediaries anymore to record the transactions, and we don't even need humans anymore to create a decision tree. We just code it in the software, we code it in the data, and it will run on its own. So we have a very interesting or short clip. I think it's created by, I think it doesn't even matter. I think it's Binance or something that explains what Ethereum is and how it works on a very main headline. It's getting late here, sorry for that one. Important to realize is we're going to do a tremendous huge deep dive based on the book of Andreas Antonopoulos, Mastering Ethereum. And we will show you how it works. We will show you how you can use it. First, before we do this, we will introduce some of the use cases, how you can use Ethereum. Important to realize, just as Bitcoin needs to focus on sound money and get the money application right, Ethereum needs to focus first on how to get the governance right. Because, of course, when you introduce flexibility in a blockchain, you also introduce some other forms of risk. So this technology is also just like Bitcoin in its very infancy, and we need to remove a lot of bugs, which of course is currently being done by huge amounts of developers. New world possibilities, but infancy phase. Let's go to the use cases in next course, and let's see what we have in petto.